Hello students, I, Mrs. Madhvi Mhatre, welcome you all in the next lecture of Mathematics 1. We have started with chapter number 3, Arithmetic Progression. In that, we have studied about the term sequence first of all. And from that, we discussed the term arithmetic progression. Arithmetic progression is a special type of sequence. Now, let us revise the important points about arithmetic progression which we have discussed in the previous lecture. So, here what you have to keep in mind is the very first point that arithmetic progression is a special type of sequence in which difference between two consecutive terms, that means tn plus 1 minus tn, for example t2 minus t1, is always constant. Okay. Then the second thing here is that the difference is denoted by the small letter d. Then the difference can be positive also, it can be negative also, or it can be zero also. This we have seen with the help of various examples. Then we can write the AP if the first term is A and common difference is A, and the AP can be written as A, the first term, A plus D, the second term, A plus 2D, the third term, and so on. Okay, so the terms in the AC are, terms in the AP are like A, A plus D, A plus 2D, and so on. Now, let's start solving practice set 3.1. I hope all of you must be ready with your textbooks and notebooks. So, let's start practice set 3.1. Okay. The very first question here in practice set 3.1, which of the following sequences are AP? If they are AP, find the common difference. Okay, so this question can be asked for 1 mark or it can be asked for 2 marks also. So here the some sequences are given and we have to decide whether it is an AP or not. That means we have to check whether the difference between two consecutive terms is constant or not. Okay. So, let us solve some examples here. I am not going to solve all because the method is similar to all. So, let's start first one here. 2, 4, 6, 8 and so on. This is a sequence. Now, we have to decide whether it is an AP or not. So, first of all, we have to write down the terms. So, write down T1 is equal to 2. That means first term is 2, t2 is equal to 4, t3 is equal to 6 and t4 is equal to 8. The terms which are given to us. After that, we have to find out the difference between two consecutive terms like this. Okay. So, we have to go for t2 minus t1. Okay. Don't write t1 minus t2. Write down t2 minus t1, 4 minus 2 is equal to 2. Then write down T3 minus T2, 6 minus 4 equal to 2, then T4 minus T3, 8 minus 6 that is 2. So what we found here, see everywhere the difference is constant, the difference is common, and therefore we can say that the given sequence is an AP. You have to write down the reason that here the difference between two consecutive terms is constant, therefore the given sequence is an AP. And if it is an AP, then we have to write down the common difference. The common difference is 2. Okay. So, if it is not an AP, you are not going to write down the common difference. The difference is common, then only it is an AP. If the difference is not constant or not common, then it is not an AP. So, if it is not an AP, you are not going to write about the common difference. Okay. Let's go towards the next sum. Question number 2. Now here the question is 2, 5 upon 2, 7 and 7 upon 3 and so on. Now you might think that it is a printing mistake, that here it may must be 7 upon 2. So if it is 7 upon 2, you have to continue with what is printed in the question. So here in the question 7 upon 3 is printed, so I am continuing with the same. So let us write down what is t1, t2, t3 and t4. So here t1 is 2, t2 is 5 upon 2, t3 is 3, t4 is 7 upon 3. Now let's find out the difference. That means we have to go for subtraction. t2 minus t1, 5 upon 2 minus 2. See, this is a fraction and this is a whole number. You know that fractions we can add or subtract only if the denominator is same. So we have to make the denominator same here. Okay, you say that you are going for the cross multiplication here, but generally we go for LCM. Here the denominator is 2. Here also we want 2, so we are going to multiply both the places by 2. So 2 2s are 4. Or in your words, you are going to go for cross multiplication. 2 2s are 4. So 5 minus 4 upon 2, that is 1 upon 2. Then next, t3 minus t2. So 3 minus 5 upon 2. Again here, see, 2 3s are 6 minus 5 upon 2. So again the answer is 1 upon 2. Now we will go for t4 minus t3. 7 upon 3 minus 3. So again see, 7 minus 3 3s are 9. 7 minus 9 upon 3, that is minus 2 upon 3. So see, here we got it as 1 upon 2. Here we got it as 1 upon 2. But here it is minus 2 upon 3. That means the difference is not constant. And therefore, this is not an AP. So you have to write down the justification that here the difference between any two consecutive terms is not constant. Then the sequence is not an AP. If you have 2 here, then you are going to get half here. Then the sequence is going to be AP. But you cannot change the question by yourself. Whatever is printed in the question, that you have to accept and you have to continue with the same. Got it? Now let's take one more example here. Fourth one, 0.3, 0.33, 0.0333. Now here is a printing mistake. It should be 0.333. So take a note of this, that here this is a printing mistake. You can see here t1 is 0.3. T2 is 0.33 and T3 is 0.333. So that point is at wrong place. You shift it here. Make this correction. Now let's check whether it's an AP or not. So you again go for the difference. That means T2 minus T1. So 0.33 minus 0.3, that is 0.03. Then T3 minus T2. 0.333 minus 0.33. So you consider one zero here and you will get the answer as 0.003. You can clearly observe here the difference is not constant and therefore this is not an AP. Okay, that T3 minus T2 is not equal to T2 minus T1. That means difference between two consecutive terms is not constant and therefore the given sequence is not an AP. Okay, now let's go ahead towards the second question. Write an AP whose first term is A and common difference is D in each of the following. We have seen that in the AP, the first term is denoted by A and the common difference is denoted by D. Values of those are given to us and we have to write down the AP. So here at least four terms you need to find and then you are going to write down the arithmetic progression or the sequence there. So let's start with the first one. Here A is equal to 10 and D is equal to 5. Now A means the first term. So you can write down T1 is equal to A and therefore the first term is 10 and D is 5. Okay. Now we can write down T2. By adding the difference, so T2 is equal to T1 plus D or A plus D, we have seen there. So 10 plus 5 is 15. Then how we are going to get T3? T3 is T2 plus D. So 15 plus 5 is 20. Then T4 is T3 plus D. 20 plus 5 is 25. Okay, so as I have said, find out at least 4 terms. And from this, you can write down the AP. So you can write down the arithmetic progression is 10, 15, 20, 25 and so on. Or you can write down therefore the AP is. As I have said, AP is a standard abbreviation which you can use. okay, you can find that it is used everywhere in textbook also. So in place of arithmetic progression, you can write down the abbreviation AP. Now let's take one more example here. All are similar, so you can solve it. Second one I am taking here, where D is 0. So A is equal to minus 3 and D is 0. So A is minus 3 means the first term is minus 3, T1 is minus 3 and D is 0. So from that we can find out T2 now. Write down the formula. T2 is equal to T1 plus D. That is minus 3 plus 0 is minus 3. Then T3 is T2 plus D, minus 3 plus 0, again minus 3. T4 is T3 plus D, again minus 3 plus 0 is minus 3. So here, since the difference is 0, all the terms we are getting same. Okay, so therefore from this we can write down the arithmetic progression as minus 3, minus 3, minus 3, minus 3 and so on. All the terms are same. Okay, it's a constant AP. Now let us see question number 5. Here A is 6 and D is minus 3. The difference is negative. So let us write down now here the first term A, that means T1 is equal to 6 and D is equal to minus 3. Now from this we can write down T2 is equal to T1 plus D, as we have written so many times. So T1 is 6 plus minus 3 is equal to 3. See here, T1 plus D, that means we are adding the difference. So this plus sign should appear. And then minus 3, again the second sign is coming, so write it in bracket. So 6 minus 3 is 3. Then the next, T3 is equal to T2 plus D. So 3 plus minus 3 is 0. Then T4 is equal to T3 plus D. 0 plus minus 3 is minus 3. And from this we can write down the sequence as, or the AP as, 6, 3, 0, minus 3 and so on. Okay, at least find 4 terms as I have said. The remaining sums from question number 2 you can solve by yourself. Now let's go towards question number 3 here. Find the first term and common difference for each of the AP. See, now here it is told that all these sequences are AP only, arithmetic progressions. We don't have to decide. Simply we have to write down what is first term and what is the common difference. The formula, you know, D is equal to Tn plus 1 minus Tn. That means the previous term you have to subtract from the next term. Okay. So let's start here. First one, 5, 1, minus 3, minus 7 and so on. Okay. So, first of all, we will write down what is T1, what is T2 and all. So, first of all, they have told us that write the first term. So, we are writing the first term T1, that is equal to A, which is equal to 5. Then, we have to find the common difference. So, write down the given terms. T2 is 1, T3 is minus 3, T4 is minus 7 and so on. And to get the difference, we have to write down the formula. Don't forget to write down the formula. Formula carries marks. That for an AP, D is equal to Tn plus 1 minus Tn. That means the next term minus the previous term. You have to do it. So any difference, any you can find out. Either you can find out for T2 minus T1. You can find for T3 minus T2. It is going to be same. Okay. So generally we are using first two terms only. So D is equal to T2 minus T1, that is 1 minus 5 is equal to minus 4. Don't do T1 minus T2, you are going to get the wrong answer. Always you should go for T2 minus T1. So in this way we have found out both the values which are asked. The first term is 5 and the common difference is minus 4, which you can write as the final answer. That therefore the first term A is 5. And the common difference D is minus 4. Okay. Let's go ahead. Second question here now. 0.6, 0.9, 1.2, 1.5 and so on. So it is very easy to write down the first term now. That first term T1 is equal to A is 0.6. Then write down the values of T2, T3 and T4. okay, T2 is 0.9, T3 is 1.2, T4 is 1.5. Now, as I have said, you can use any two consecutive terms, like you can find T2 minus T1, you can find T3 minus T2, you can find T4 minus T3 also. Any two consecutive terms will do. But you need to write down the formula every time, that for an APD is equal to Tn plus 1 minus Tn, that is T2 minus T1, 0.9 minus 0.6 is equal to 0.3. Okay, so in this way, the first term is 0.6 and the common difference is 0.3, which you can write as a final answer in statement, that therefore the first term is 0.6 and the common difference is 0.3. Okay, now let's go ahead. Now we are going to study the important formula to find out nth term of an AP. We have seen so many AP, and if we want to find out the general term of the AP, like in natural numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on, if I want to find the 20th term, I will say that 20th term is 20. Why? Because you know natural numbers, they differ by 1 and immediately we can say the term. But it is not so for every AP. So we need to know the formula for nth term or general term of an AP. So you know that in an AP, the first term is given by small a and the common difference is given by d. So here we can write down that T1 is equal to a. Then we have seen T2 is equal to a plus d, T3 is equal to a plus 2d, T4 is equal to a plus 3d and so on. So from that, we can get the formula of Tn as Tn is equal to a plus n minus 1 outside the bracket d. Tn means general term of the AP. For example, if I want to find the 15th term of the AP, then value of n is 15. A is first term as you know and d is common difference. So you have to by heart this formula. Tn is equal to a plus n minus 1 outside the bracket d. Okay. If you know the formula, you can solve any type of sum. All of you please go through all the solved examples in the textbook as they are equally important. Now by using this formula, we can solve practice set 3.2. So let's move towards practice set 3.2. Now, practice set 3.2, question number 1 is activity based, where there are so many questions are asked of same type. I am discussing only one here. Remaining you can solve by yourself. Only boxes are there and you have to fill the correct numbers there. Okay. So here APs are already provided. And we have to write down the correct numbers. The first AP here is 1, 8, 15, 22 and so on. So here we have to write down value of A. A means first term. Okay, so first term here is 1. So you have to write down 1 here. Again they have asked for T1. T1 means again the first term. So again 1 will come here. Then T2 is 15. T3 is 22. I'm sorry, T2 is 8. Here and T3 is 15. T4 is 22, which is not asked. Once again, see A is 1, that means first term is 1. Again, T1 is asked, so same value will come here. Then T2, second term is 8. T3, the third term is 15. Now they have asked us T2 minus T1. So T2 is what? 8 minus T1 is 1. So 8 minus 1 answer is 7. Then T3 minus T2, T3 is 15, minus T2 is 8, so 15 minus 8 answer is 7. And from that we can write down the value of D is 7. The difference which is constant, the common difference which is asked here, that is 7. In this way you can complete all the questions. All are very much similar. Only you have to write down the terms and then you have to find out the difference. Now let's go towards the second question here. Decide whether following sequence is an AP. If so, find 20th term of the progression. The sequence is provided to us. It is not told that it is an AP. We have to decide whether it is an AP. And if it is an AP, then we are going to proceed further. If it is not an AP, then we have to stop there. So first of all, we have to check whether the given sequence is an AP, as we have done in 3.1. Okay. So here, first of all, we have to write down all the terms. Here, so many terms are given. You can go for at least 4 terms. So let's start here. We will write down what is T1. T1 is minus 12. T2 is minus 5. T3 is 2, T4 is 9. So at least you consider 4 terms. Now let's find out the difference. That means T2 minus T1. So minus 5 minus of minus 12. Write it properly. The next term minus the previous one. So minus 5 minus of minus 12. So minus 5 plus 12. See, this minus and minus will become plus. So minus 5 plus 12, the answer is 7. Now T3 minus T2, that is 2 minus of minus 5. So 2 plus 5 is 7. Then T4 minus T2, 9 minus 2 is 7. See, so observe here, everywhere the difference is 7. 7. It is constant. So we can say that here the difference between two consecutive terms is constant. Therefore, the given sequence is an AP. Okay, so the first part is done. And if it is an AP, we have to find out the 20th term. That means the general term which they have asked. So 20th term means here we have to find out T20. Value of n is 20 here. You know the formula. Tn is equal to a plus n minus 1 outside the bracket d. That means we need a first term. That is minus 12. Then we need D, difference, which we have found out already, that is 7. And then value of N also is known to us, that is 20. Okay, so we can find out T20. That means the 20th term we can find out here because we know all the things there. Now let us go ahead. So here A is minus 12, as I have said. D is 7 and we have to find out T20. 20th term. Okay, that means value of n is 20. So first of all, you have to write down the formula. That is Tn is equal to a plus n minus 1 outside the bracket d. Okay, so as you know, a value of n is 20. Everywhere n you will replace by 20. Both the places. Then a you will replace by 7 and d, a you will replace by minus 12 and d you will replace by 7. So the next step is to substitute values. So what we can write here, therefore T20 is equal to minus 12 plus 20 minus 1 multiplied by 7. Okay. Now 20 minus 1 is 19. So we can write it like this, minus 12 plus 19 into 7. First, go for multiplication. Okay, so this will be minus 12 plus 133. 19 sevens are 133. And then 133 minus 12, the answer is 121. So T20, the 20th term is 121. And finally, you can write down the answer in words. That thus, the 20th term of the given AP is 121. So this question was in two parts. First part was to decide whether it is an AP or what, and then to find. The next question also is similar, so all of you solve it. I'm going towards the next question, which is different, okay? So question number 2, 3, 4 and 5, they are similar. Everywhere you have to use formula of Tn. So those sums you will solve by yourself. Now question number 6 is different and it is an important question. Find how many 3-digit natural numbers are divisible by 5. Now they will ask for 4 also. Here the number can change. They will ask you, find how many 3-digit numbers are divisible by 4. They can ask for 8 also. They can ask for 7 also. So any number can come here. But this question is very much important. three digit natural numbers. You know that the smallest three digit natural number is 100 and the highest one is 999. So we have to find out how many numbers between these two are divisible by 5. So here also we are going to use the formula of TN. It is very clear, but here we don't have to find TN. Instead, we have to find out N. How many terms are there? How many three digit numbers are there? Means how many terms are there? So please take a note of this here. N is unknown. So we will make use of the smallest three digit number and the biggest three digit number, and then we will try to write down the numbers which are divisible by 5. Okay, so the three digit numbers, natural numbers to be more specific, are divisible by 5. As I have said, the smallest three digit natural number is 100 and it is divisible by 5. The next we can write by adding 5, so it is 105. Next is 110 and so on. Now the biggest one is 999, that is not divisible by 5. Okay, then 998 not divisible, 97 not divisible, 96 not divisible. So 995 is the biggest three digit number which is divisible by 5. Okay, so here while writing this AP, we have to write down the last term. Okay, and we have to find out how many terms are there in between. So here what we can say is, this is an AP first of all. You have to write down, this is an AP. You can clearly observe that the difference is of 5. So this is an AP that you have to write down. And in this AP, the first term A is 100 and the difference D is 5. That you write down first of all. The given sequence is an AP. And here A is 100 and D is 5. Now this is the last term. So we will consider this as TN. Okay. So let TN is equal to 995. And from that we have to find out N. Means how many terms are there here. Okay. So we know TN, we know A, we know D. Only N is unknown to us. So we can substitute these values in the formula of TN and we can get the answer. So write down the formula of TN first of all. TN is equal to A plus inside the bracket N minus 1 outside the bracket D. Now put the values here. TN is 95. So replace TN by 995. Don't write 995 in the place of N. You are wrong. Please keep in mind that TN, the nth term is 995, N is not 995, N we have to find out. Okay, so here we are going to write down 995, A is 100, N we don't know, so don't write it, and D is 5. So substitute the values like this, 995 is equal to 100 plus N minus 1 outside the bracket 5. Okay, now solve it. You can solve it in many ways, like somebody will shift this 100 here first and then open the bracket. Somebody will open the bracket first. Okay, so any way you can solve. Like here, see, both the places, both the things are done simultaneously. That 100 is subtracted, so we got 895 and this bracket is open. That is 5n minus 5. Now this minus 5 is shifted again towards the left hand side. So it became plus 5. So 895 plus 5 is 5n. So here 895 plus 5 we are going to get 900. 900 is equal to 5n. Okay. And from that n is equal to 900 divided by 5 is equal to 180. Value of n is 180. And therefore, there are 180 three-digit natural numbers which are divisible by 5. Okay? So, in this way, you are going to solve the sums. The remaining sums we will discuss in next lecture. You try to solve all the sums which are given as homework. Practice is more important. Keep this in mind and solve the sums. solve each and every sum from the textbook. Also go through all the solved examples so that it is possible for you to solve any sum if it is appeared in exam. Okay, you can solve it very easily if you know all the things. Then by heart the formula, try to understand the concepts. So textbook, referring to textbook in mathematics or reading mathematics textbook is equally important. Okay, so please don't ignore it. Go through it, go through all the solved examples and solve the remaining sums as homework. Okay, so students, we will meet in next lecture. Till that, you stay home, stay safe, take care of yourself. Thank you, students.